Today I'm going to be telling you the top 5 best value for money cars in ERLC. So if you do enjoy this video or if it helps you out at all, please do make sure you drop a like and also subscribe on the road to 100k, but let's get straight into it. Okay, so as you can see and as you all know, there is a lot of cars in ERLC and I own pretty much all of them. I did own all of them, but obviously with updates and stuff they've started adding a lot more. However, I have used all of them. I've bought them in a private server, which obviously the information doesn't save, but I have used them all before. Like, there's no way I wouldn't have ever used this one, right? So yes, there is a lot of vehicles and I have done similar videos to this in the past, but obviously we've had new vehicles in the game now, so this is kind of a more updated top 5 best cars in ERLC type video. So let's get straight into it. The first one, I'm sure most of you will know, it is the Falcon Rampage, which is obviously the Ford Bronco. Ignore that it's in hot pink. I do not know why that is. Don't question it. But this vehicle is really, really nice. I'm sure you've all seen so many people talking about how good this vehicle is. It's really, really cheap and it is like the best off-roading vehicle by far. And it's a really, really good vehicle in every other way as well. It's really, really fast. It's really, really cool to drive. It drives really nice. If you look here when you turn, like the suspension, how it like tilts like that, it's really, really cool. And you can literally drive up mountains with this. Like, not like literal ones like this. We probably won't get up here. Yeah, I don't know why I thought that would work. But there's like a point over by the housing suburbs that you can just drive up onto the mountain in this Ford Bronco. And you can drive around the whole map once you're on top of the mountain and drive around it on the mountain, if that makes sense. So it's really, really cool. Really, really like that, this Ford Bronco. And yeah, like I said, it's quite cheap, so I don't really have anything to say about this. It looks great as well. The wheels are nice and unique. One problem, I don't think you can change the color of these wheels. You might be able to, I don't know, I haven't tried, but I think even if you did it would look weird, so just keep them as black if I was you. And obviously, like all cars, you can't change the color of this black section here. You can only change the bit that's actually pink. Everything that's pink you can see on this car, you can change. Everything that's black, you can't change, really. So yeah, very, very cool vehicle. But let's move on to the next one, which is the Bullhorn Determinator, which is this one just here, the Bullhorn Determinator SFP Fury. Now, the reason I like this one is because it's quite cheap and it's very, very fast. It's a really, really fast car. I must say I don't use it all that much, but that's just because I use like the McLaren and stuff. But if you're just starting out, I would really recommend this car. It's very, very good. You can see how fast we're going right now. This is very fast, actually. Wow. Okay, I think the Bugatti goes like 170, 180, and this goes 160, and it's not too expensive, especially not expensive compared to the price of the Bugatti. So this is very, very nice. A very nice vehicle. I'm not sure how fast the Bugatti goes, but last time I checked it, I think it went 170. So for saying this car goes 160 is quite extreme. So I think you should definitely check this car out if you just want some speed for a cheap price, really. And also, if you want to have like an upgrade from this but like the same car, then you can get this one. It's like pretty much the same, but you can see it's just a little bit slower. And also, if you really like this car as well, you can also get this one. It's a little bit slower, as you can see here, but it's really, really nice. You've got like the black sections on this. Obviously, you can't change the color of the black bits, so just make sure you're aware of that. And obviously, this is a wide body version, so it doesn't look the same as this one, but it's still very, very cool nevertheless. So yes, very nice vehicle, highly recommend it. Probably the best vehicle for speed at a cheap price, so yeah, check that out. Car. And now we have one that's quite a favorite, and now we have one that's kind of been forgotten about in ERLC, to be honest. It is the Navara Horizon, also known as the 2013 Nissan GTR. As you can see, it looks very, very nice. As you can see, it's definitely one of the older models for ERLC. You can see a lot more of the less detail compared to what we have on current cars now. But that only means that it's likely this car will get updated at some point in the future. But it's quite cheap and it is quite fast. It's obviously a Nissan GTR. So if you like a Nissan GTR, why would you not buy it? It's a perfect car to do that if you do like the Nissan GTR, which the Nissan GTR is a pretty cool car, I can't lie. And yeah, this one is pretty fast in the ERLC. Again, it looks really nice. It is a slightly older, a bit dated model, but that will probably get fixed at some point in the future. And it's still not bad anyway, it still looks really, really nice. And of course, you don't have to have gold wheels, you of course can change that. This is the car I used when we first got the mod shop update, when you could like change the color of the rims like all them years ago, and I don't use it that much, so I still haven't changed it all the way since back then. That is literally ages when you think about it. That is crazy. But yes, let's move on to the next one, which is a very, very basic one. So it is the Allison Slick. Now, I've made many videos on this in the past, and unfortunately, this vehicle has been patched and been fixed. Now, this vehicle is about $30,000. I think it's like $29,000 to be specific. This vehicle used to be almost as fast as the Bugatti. It was pretty much the same speed as like the Lamborghini or what is now the McLaren. It was pretty much the same speed, and now it's not. They've definitely buffed it a little bit. We'll go onto the highway and test out the top speed of it now, but I remember seeing that it is definitely not that fast anymore, which is a shame because it was a very, very cool experience to drive around the map at 170 miles an hour in a Honda Civic. You can see it's now 107 miles per hour, and it used to be very, very fast. I made many videos and YouTube shorts on this car and how fast it was, but yes, it is sadly fixed now. However, it is still a fast car. 107 miles per hour for $30,000 is pretty good. You know, the Bugatti's 170 miles per hour and it's like $2 million. This is $30,000 and it's only 70 miles per hour slower. I don't know, I think that's a pretty good deal if you ask me. So yeah, if this is like one of your, if you're just starting out in ERLC, then I definitely do recommend this car. It's very cheap, it's a great starter car, and it's just perfect really. So yes, that was the Honda Civic, also known as